Let's get reaction now from political expert Avigdor Eskin, who is in Israel. Well, Erdogan has vowed to resolve the crisis when he returns to the country. How do you think he's going to do that?
Well, first, good evening. Blessings from the holy city of Jerusalem. You know, I happened to be a witness to the unrest in Turkey. I spent Sunday and Monday with the demonstrators in Istanbul this week. And I can tell you, if we were talking 2 years ago about Arab Spring, so now we are facing Turkish autumn. This is exactly the opposite process of what we were facing in Egypt and many other places in our region. We see that this wave of Islamism is becoming sometimes a really very heavy burden to the people, and they don't want to continue with that. And this is what the Turkish people were saying.
Well, you say now, you were amongst those people. Can I just ask you? You say you're amongst
officials. Say
you say you're amongst those people. You were there during the demonstrations. What sort of people are they? What sort of representation of society?
I was not participating as an active.
Sure, but who's there?
I was not participating in any riots or demonstration. I just was an observer there to tell the truth. And the truth is that the unrest was absolutely spontaneous. You know, people even didn't carry any slogans in English. People were not prepared. They just came spontaneously from all parts of Istanbul. Now, it was not only Taksim Square. It was everywhere in the city. You could even see demonstrators on the way to the airport just marching in a very, very, very restrained and very peaceful way, we must say. Now, unlike, you know, I remember unrest in Romania in 1989, which was resulted by the revolution against Ceausescu, and remember Moscow in 91 and 93. The amount of people participating and their real determination to reach the goal in Turkey is much stronger than in any other place I saw in the world. I mean, the events there are really very serious, and Turkey is not going to be the same tomorrow as it was yesterday. It's a different country already. Even if we are talking about certain parallels with Paris 1968, the cultural atmosphere is different, because we are talking about the people who are students, intellectuals, professionals. They were all there. They were all there. And there was no sign in any part in Istanbul that there was any even smallest gathering of the government and the ruling Islamist party supporters. This was just amazing that the street was conquered absolutely by the protesters, and even the police was sympathetic to them. I saw it.
And what about the role of the military in all of this? You say the situation is extremely dangerous now for Erdogan and the government. Where's the military? We haven't seen them at all.
Well, the military is waiting. As you know, many generals and even former chief of staff of Turkey are in prison now. I mean, this is a very special situation when they are waiting for the developments, because the army will take control only if there will be more serious disturbances. They're waiting. Maybe the prime minister and the president will start negotiating with the demonstrators. Maybe it will be some appeasing process. I mean, they're still waiting for something good to happen. But if instead of negotiating with his own people, the prime minister will keep conveying to them his tough message, even stirring them up more, then you will see next week or week after something from the army. And Turkey, as you know, has a culture of kind of military regime, democracy, military regime. These things happened to them in the past, and nobody will be surprised that it will happen again now.
Live from Jerusalem, political expert Avigdor Eskin, thank you very much indeed for your thoughts on this.